Hey, it's Jake Gray. That is so old, but it's gonna stay. So I wanted to start doing some book videos again, and I figured, hey, it's been quite a while since I've done any videos at all, let alone book videos, so I should just restart on the whole BookTube thing. When I first started doing book-related videos, I did a thing. It was a tag. I think it was called the, like, Welcome to BookTube tag or something like that. I don't know. The questions were really boring. Like, really, really, really boring. But I found another tag. So this tag that we're gonna do today is called the BookTube Newbie Tag. Yep. Title just makes me cringe when I say it out loud or read it actually, but you know what? The questions are much better than the other ones, so we're gonna go with this and we're gonna roll with it. And I actually haven't even read the questions, I just already know that they're better than the other tag. So let's go! Question one! Why did you start this channel? Okay, I started this channel a very long time ago. It's not just book related, and I was bored. That is the simple thing about it. I started this channel because I was bored. I have kept it going because partly because I was bored and partly because I did actually kind of enjoy doing it. Some of it is book related, and the book related parts, like every different category of this that I have done, every different type of video that I have done on this channel has been because it is a thing that I enjoy doing, a thing that I am passionate about, a thing that I want to share with the world. I guess. I don't know what I'm saying half the time. Yeah, let's leave it at that. Question two! What are some fun and unique things that you can bring to BookTube? I don't know about fun, but I mean it can be fun because half the time I don't know what I'm saying and I just ramble on and things come out of my mouth and they don't always make sense, but sometimes they can be quite amusing. So I guess that. Maybe. Also, I feel like there are books that people don't talk about as much, and maybe I'll end up talking about some of those. Give some different books some talking aboutness. That was an example of the rambling nonsense not making any sense, very confusing bleh that comes out of my mouth. Question three! What are you most excited for about this new channel? Okay, not a new channel. Most excited to finally get back into things, start things up again, talk about some things, do some exciting things. Whatever it is I end up doing, I don't know, I'm sure it's gonna be great fun. Give me something to do, and it's not just all gonna be the same thing all the time. Because every video is gonna be different, every video is unique, and I am always saying different things. Like, no two videos will ever be the same. Except maybe the intro. That's just. Question four! Why do you love reading? Because books are good. They're enjoyable. They're interesting. They get you hooked. Some of the stories are just like exciting, they're fun, they're funny. Entertaining, amusing. They get you away from the space that you're in. Like, you just get fully invested in a book and you are just properly there with it. And like, sometimes I'll be reading and I just forget that I exist, and then something snaps me out of it and I'm just like, wait, hold on, I'm a real person. That's a thing. Question five. What book or series got you into reading? Okay. I've always liked reading. Always liked reading. I don't think there's any one particular book or series that got me into reading. I don't think that's like a fair question to ask. I don't know, but I can tell you a couple of series that I have loved since I was a kid that just made me want to keep reading and reading and reading and reading and reading and reading. The main one's probably these. Spelled very pleasant. I would actually like. I recommend this to like everyone I possibly can because no matter what your preferred genre is, okay, almost no matter what your preferred genre is, you could find it in these books. Like, there's only like a couple of genres that don't fit into these, you know, and it's just
perfection.
There's also, I don't know if I need to say it, but Goosebumps books. When I was a kid, I really liked the Mary-Kate and Ashley books. Yeah. That's a little bit cringe, but I still have them all. And I actually did end up getting most of them. I've been collecting them from, op shops, since I found out they existed. I've just been collecting them from op shops. I have almost all of them. I think there's only a few that I'm missing at this point. And I still keep my eye out for the ones that I am missing. There we go. I'm not gonna deny that. It's a thing. I was asked what I read when I was a kid, and I'm just like, I don't know. Yeah, I think mostly what I read when I was a kid was Goosebumps. I was obsessed with Goosebumps when I was a kid. And then I got really into Scuderi Pleasant, and I just will not let Derek Landy go. It'll be in my heart forever. Number 6! What questions would you ask your favourite booktubers? Okay, so, here's the thing. I don't really watch very many YouTubers. I mean, YouTubers, yeah, that works. I meant booktubers, but I don't watch very many YouTubers in general. The main person that I am subscribed to on YouTube that talks about books is Jenna Moresi, and I don't think that it really counts as a booktuber because she's an author who talks about her own books but also answers questions about, like, the writing process. She talks about writing more than books, you know? Like, sometimes I'll go through patches and I'll just, like, go and watch a bunch of booktuber videos, but I'm not really, like, that dead set on any one particular booktuber, you know? Like, I just... Does that make sense? My god, I'm a failure. Guess we found the imposter. Number 7. What challenges do you think starting a booktube channel will be the hardest to overcome? Okay, so as I said, this isn't particularly specifically a booktube channel. It's a lot of things. And I think the hardest part is that I haven't had a consistent schedule or anything with making videos for a very long time. I think it's gonna be very hard to get back into that. But it is something that I am motivated to do. It's something that I want to do. It's something that I've been wanting to do for quite a while. But I think that it will be difficult. I think it's going to be hard to do. But at the same time, I believe that if I stick with it, that I can do it. I just have to actually stick with it. 8. When did you start reading? When I was able to, I don't know, is this like what age did my eyes start working and I began to understand words? I don't know, I think I'm pretty sure I was reading like kindy, not like chapter books, I wasn't reading chapter books in kindy, but I was reading and just never stopped. 9. Where do you read? Just wherever is the most convenient or suitable at the time, really. Sometimes I will read sitting on my bed, sometimes I will read on the floor, sometimes I will just sit in the corner of a room and just have a book. Sometimes I will walk around and read. I read on buses. Where I'm currently staying, there is a chair outside that's really comfy, and I tend to put that in the nice warm spot that's not in like the direct sun but still has a little bit of sun. I'm kind of like a cat. I want to sit in a comfy chair in the sun but not in the sun. Yeah, it's a good spot to read, and I do end up in that chair reading most days at some point. 10. What kind of books do you like to read? Okay, that is a complicated question because it depends on my mood. Like, I just finished reading I just finished reading this, and now I am out of her books. I've read all of them now. I need more. Karen M. McManus, I really enjoyed her books. Like, you know, most YA mystery sort of books are insanely predictable. Most YA books in general are insanely predictable, but I have actually really enjoyed Karen's books. And there's another one coming out later this year. I'm so excited. Gonna get it like the day it comes out, or you know, whatever day I'm next in town for work. I work in a bookshop, woohoo! Ow, Scarborough Pleasant. Need I say it? No, not really, but we're gonna say it again, because, you know, I really like Stephen King as well. This is the Stephen King book I am up to at the moment. I am not getting very far with it, but I am reading it. What else do I read? Alex Gino. Really like Alex Gino's books. I did enjoy reading these books by this person. I'm just trying to pick them up. My books are in boxes at the moment. This series, it's a trilogy. I did really enjoy them. I read them first, like pretty much when they first came out. I reread them again a couple of years ago and went, oh my goodness, I shouldn't have read these when I did. That was not appropriate. But I still really enjoyed some aspects of them. I do have some issues with them, and maybe I'll do a video about them one day. Who knows? Anything is possible. I just read what I feel like reading at the time. If something catches my eye, I'll be like, yep, that's a book. Let's read it. And sometimes it happens and sometimes it doesn't. Yeah. I don't really have a preferred genre or style or anything. Yeah. Not the most decisive person in the world. 11. What does your book collection look like? Okay, so as I said, a lot of my books are in boxes at the moment. I have 3 boxes of books here with me, but I have a whole heap of boxes of books that are currently, dare I say it, in a storage unit. They're out of access for me right now. Which is really sad. My poor books, but I will pop up a photo of the last time I took a photo of my bookcases. So one of those bookcases, there are several shelves. I believe it was 3 or 4 shelves that are double stacked. That means there's 2 rows of books in there. And there was also quite a large pile on the floor in a different section of my room because they did not fit in that bookcase. So, yeah. And I've bought quite a lot of books since then as well. I've probably bought, I reckon I've purchased probably about 20 books this year. No, it's definitely more than 20. I bought a lot of books this year. I haven't read a lot of books this year. I've only read 18 books this year so far, but yeah. And that is the whole thing. I don't know what that was. This is the kind of fun stuff, fun and unique things that I can bring to BookTube. So that was the BookTube newbie tag. I will pop the questions in the thingy thing. You know the thing. You know the one. Woo. Yeah. And if you have any specific things that you want to talk about or do, or like this book tags or book related questions, ask me questions, I don't know, or if there's like a book that you're like, hey, I reckon you'd like this, let me know and I might read it. So, woo! Thanks for watching, stay awesome, go read some books.